To be fair, I was quite lucky. For my C1 fracture, that actually touched my spinal cord when I made it. I was working a site clearance, driving a 6-ton dumper, and I was tipping mud from an 8-foot mound, and I went to the top of it, and we got down to see that it was the edge, and it upturned and dropped 8 foot and landed on top of it. And then fractured my neck at C1 and broke it at C6 and 7. The feelings and emotions in your head, the stuff that goes through, why me, and then the more you realise when you get up in your chair that your life's changed a lot, a whole lot. I've came to terms with my spinal injury, I know there's nothing going to change, so if I don't have my wheelchair anymore, I know I've not got my legs. Being out and pushing and my arms were in agony, it was hurting. So then decided, what can I do to make it better? I started playing wheelchair rugby, then I was introduced into being able to go to the gym, which then made me a lot stronger. I've been able to transfer in my car, get my chair in and out, which I couldn't do at the very start. The final settlement helped me buy a house that was big enough to incorporate my own gym in it, saving me having to go looking for gyms, council gyms that never had any equipment for me, so that I then got a big enough house to put my own gym in it. And a lot of people that don't receive anything and just have a spinal cord injury for their own, and it's nothing but struggle. It was phenomenal, the treatment I got with Digby Brown. You weren't treated as somebody who was in a chair, you were still a human being no matter what. You were still treated as the same as equal as everybody else, even though you've obviously had a traumatic accident that's left you with a disability. They actually knew more than what I did, what I needed at that time. They've obviously had personal injury settlements through this kind of thing before. I could get on with my rehab and concentrate on that and leave the legal side to the Digby Brown. I think it was 4 weeks before Christmas, Digby Brown phoned me to tell me that he'd received an interim payment from my lawyers, which was a godsend at the time because we basically had nothing. So we went from worrying about not being able to have a house to having being able to spend a Christmas for a first in the house. They're trained in personal injury settlements, you know what I mean? It's like, I think it's very important. It's like getting a gardener to do a plumber's job in it. It's just not right, you know. Considering where I was at the very start to what I look at now, and people talk to nurses and everything else and they see how far I've came on, you don't actually notice it yourself when you actually, until you sit back and take stock of what your life's been like. I've got a high level spinal injury, a 6-7. It's really high, which, and being able to get yourself in and out of bed and drive cars and everything else at my level of injury is it's not a lot of people can get there. Going through being able to turn the telly with your thumb, being able to brush your teeth, shave, everything. Like, there's no comparison, it's night and day, do you know what I mean? You don't realise that it's not just one wee thing you lose with your spinal injury, it's a combination of things, all the way from the top to the bottom. So if you're going to have a work-related action, then the best lawyers to work with are Digby Brown in my eyes.